वेलकम बैक। प्रीवियसली वी लर्न इन डिटेल हाउ टू फाइंड द माइनर ऑफ एन एलिमेंट एज वेल एज कोर फैक्टर ऑफ एन एलिमेंट। लेट अस डिस्कस सम ऑफ द अदर केसेस दैट कम्स अंडर मैट्रिक्स। नेक्स्ट वन एडजॉइंट ऑफ ए मैट्रिक्स और एडजॉइंट मैट्रिक्स। We all know how to find the minor of an element as well as the cofactor of an element. So, adjoint of the matrix or adjoint matrix is a continuation of the cofactor of an element. Adjoint matrix of a given square matrix is the transpose of the matrix formed by cofactors of the elements of a given square matrix taken in the order alpha. I hope you didn't understand anything. Okay, we know how to find the cofactor of an element. For example, if you are dealing with a matrix of the order 3, so there will be 9 elements because 3 rows and 3 columns, so there will be 9 elements or 9 items. And we all know how to find the cofactor of each element. Once you find the cofactor of each element, you need to make a new matrix on the basis of cofactors of each element so that you will get a new matrix. I hope you understand the concept. You all know how to find the cofactor. So if you are dealing with a matrix of the order 3, you will get a cofactor, 9 cofactors of the given matrix. So if you are using that cofactor values in the position where all the elements are given that question, instead of those elements, if you are substituting it with its cofactors, then you will get a new matrix. If you take the transpose of that new matrix, that particular matrix or the new matrix formed by the transpose of the new matrix. Don't get confused. First of all, you got a matrix of the order 3. And we are creating a new matrix on the basis of cofactors of the first matrix. And now if you are taking the transpose of the new matrix means based on the cofactors. So the transposed matrix you got, that is known as adjoint matrix. I hope you got a vague idea about the concept. With an example, you will get a clear picture about it. So remember, regarding adjoint, you need to find cofactors of each element and note it in a new matrix. Then take the transpose of that new matrix. Now you will get another matrix. It is known as adjoint. So let us discuss with an example. Find the adjoint of a matrix. A is given. It's in the order of 3 into 3. Usually you will get a matrix in the order 3. Usually all these activities are done on square matrices. So it will be 3 or it will be 3 because if it is in the order of 2, then it will be a simple question. And if it is in the order of 4, then it will be a time-consuming question. So, anyway, prepare for anything. So, the question A is given, matrix, and you find the adjoint of the matrix, this one. And within the question, you are asked to verify that A into adjoint of A equal adjoint of A into A equal determinant AI. Actually, in this question, you need to find only the adjoint, but within the question, you are asked to verify a theorem. Actually, this is a theorem which we need not have to study, but in the question, you are asked to prove if you are multiplying A with an adjoint, and if you are multiplying adjoint with A, and if you are multiplying determinant with I means unity or identity. So you will get three matrices that will be equal. So as per the theorem, it has to be equal, but you need to verify that whether it is equal or not. So we will deal that part at the end because it's quite easy. Here the concept is multiplication. We all know how to find the multiplication. The main part is how to find the adjoint. So here matrix A is given. And previously I said that adjoint means if you are taking the transpose of a cofactor matrix. So first of all, let us deal with how to find the cofactor. So first of all, I go with 1. You can select any number because you need to find the cofactor of all the numbers. So the order doesn't matter. Just remember, if you are selecting the particular element, you need to note it down the cofactor of that particular element. Don't get confused or mixed up. So first, I am selecting 1. So if I am selecting 1, the cofactor of that particular element. So whenever you are selecting an element within a matrix, name it as A subscript, whatever the position of that element. Here the 1 is in the first row, first column, so we can write A11 is alpha 11. Alpha 11 means cofactor. For representing cofactor, we are using alpha 11. And cofactor of an element is, the equation is minus 1 raised to I plus J into minor of an element. So instead of that, we are directly substituting it, minus 1 raised to I plus J. Here A11 means, sorry, it is A11, it is A11. A11 can be written as minus 1 raised to I plus J, 1 plus 1 into minor. In minor means if you are selecting 1, the corresponding rows and columns will be cancelled. The remaining numbers is 2 and minus 3, minus 1 and 3. So 2, minus 3, minus 1 and 3. You all know how to find the cofactor and minor. So 2 into 3, 6, minus, minus 1 into minus 3, it will be minus 3. So 6 minus 3, because 6 minus, minus 1 into minus 3, it will be plus, so it will be 6 minus 3. So you will get 3. Remember, here 1 represents this one. Minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1. We know that if you are getting an even number, it will be a positive one. So I am using this part in this part of the computation. Here for computing this particular submatrix, I am not including this minus 1 raised to 1 plus a. So in order to avoid the confusion, I am not including this part in this computation. Here in this computation, I am including only the numbers within this matrix. So after solving these numbers within this matrix, you will get 6 minus 3 is this 3, this one. And how you got 1 is this one, minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1. That part is taken here. In order to avoid the confusion only, I am using like that. You can use anyway. You can either include this computation along with this 6 minus 3. So it can be written as minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1 into 6 minus 3. So in order to avoid a confusion, only writing it like this. So 6 minus 3, it will be 3. And here it is minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1, you will get 2. 2 is an even number, so minus 1 will become 1. So 1 into 3, it is 3. So finally, you got cofactor of this element is 3. This element is represented by A11. So, first one, you got the value. Next element is, so for the first element, you got cofactor 3. So, the next one, we are going for the next item. 1. So, the cofactor of next one is 1, 2, because this is in the first row, second column. So 1, 2 is alpha 1, 2, which is written as minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2, because it's the first row and the second column. Here the 1, 2. So minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2. When this element is selected, the corresponding row and columns are neglected. So the remaining numbers are 1, 2 and minus 3, 3. 1, minus 3, 2 and 3. 1, minus 3, 2 and 3. So if you cross multiply, 3 minus minus 6, so it will become 3 plus 6. 3 plus 6 will become 9.
Here it is minus 1 raised to 1 plus 3. 1 plus 3 you will get odd number, so the sign remains the same. So minus 1 into 9 you will get minus 10. So now you got the cofactor of the second element, that is minus 9. So now you have found two cofactors. So first one is over, second element is over. So we are going for the next element. Again it's 1. So it will be written as cofactor of 1, 3. 1, 3, we all know what is meant by 1, 3. 1, 3 means first row, third column. So A13 is alpha 1, 3, which can be written as minus 1 raised to 1 plus 3, because first row, third column. The here the same 1, 3 is written as 1 plus 3 into, when this element is selected, the corresponding rows and columns are neglected, so the remaining numbers are 1, 2, 2 and minus 1. So 1, 2, 2 and minus 1. If you cross multiply it, minus 1, minus 2 into 2, 4, you will get minus 1, minus 4, it will be minus 5. And here it is minus 1 raised to 1 plus 3. So 1 plus 3 will become 4. So minus 1 raised to 4 means it's an even number, so it will be 1. So 1 into minus 5, it is minus 5. So you now got the cofactor of 1, that is minus 5. So row is completed. So we will go for the next item, the next element in the second row, that is 1. Again it is 1. Okay. Cofactor of that particular element can be written as cofactor of 2, 1. Why it is 2, 1? Because it is in the second row and first column. So A21 can be written as alpha 21. So it is written as minus 1 raised to I plus j. I plus j means in which row and which column? It is in the first, second row and first column. So it is written as 2 plus 1. So when this element is selected, the corresponding row and columns are neglected, so the remaining numbers are 1, 1, minus 1, 3. See, 1, 1, minus 1, 3. So 1 into 3, 3 plus. Here plus is arrived because 3 minus minus 1, so it will become plus 1. So 3 plus 1, you got 4. Wait, here it is minus 1 raised to 2 plus 1. Here 2 plus 1, you will get an 3. It's an odd number, so the sign remains the same. So minus 1 into 4, it will be minus 4. So the cofactor of this element is minus 4. So next item. Next item is 2. So the cofactor of next element is represented by A22, or otherwise known as alpha 22, that is minus 1 raised to 2 plus 2. Minus 1 raised to 2 plus 2 means minus 1 raised to I plus j. I means in which row and j means which column. It is in the second row and second column, so it will be 2 plus 2. So when this element is selected, corresponding row and corresponding columns are neglected, so the remaining numbers are 1, 1, 2, 3. See, 1, 1, 2, 3. So 1 into 3, 3 minus 1 into 2, 2. So it will be 3 minus 2, it is 1. And here it is minus 1 raised to 2 plus 2. Minus 1 raised to 4. 4 is an even number, so the sign is positive. So 1 into 1, 1. So now you got the cofactor of the next element, 1. So we go for the next item, or next element within the same matrix, minus 3. So it can be written as cofactor of A23 or alpha 23, which can be written as minus 1 raised to I plus j. Minus 1 raised to I means in which row and j means in which column. Minus 3 is in the second row and third column, so it can be written as 2 plus 3. So when minus 3 is selected, corresponding rows and columns are neglected. The remaining numbers are 1, 1, 2 and minus 1. 1, 1, 2, minus 1. So 1 into minus 1, minus 1. 2 into 1, 2. So minus 1, minus 2, it will be minus 3. And remember, don't forget to take this one. Minus 1 raised to 2 plus 3. 2 plus 3, you will get an odd number, that is 5.
So minus 1 raised to 5 means you need to multiply minus 1 5 times. I hope you all know what is meant, how to take the multiplication. That's why I am not repeating the same again and again. So minus 1 raised to 5 means you need to multiply minus 1 5 times. So if you are multiplying 5 times, it's an odd number series. So you will definitely end in minus sign. So minus 1 into minus 3, you will get 3. So you got the cofactor of the next element within the matrix, that is 3. So we will go for the next item or next element within the matrix, 2. So it can be written as cofactor of A 3 1. 3 means third row, first column. It is written as alpha 3 1. So it will be minus 1 raised to 3 plus 1 into, when this number is selected, automatically rows and columns are neglected. Remaining numbers are 1, 1, 2 and minus 3. 1, 1, 2 and minus 3. So 1 into minus 3, minus 3, minus 2, that will become minus 5. Here it is minus 1 raised to 3 plus 1. That is an even number. 3 plus 1, you will get 4. Minus 1 raised to 4 means it will be plus 1. So 1 into minus 5, it is minus 5. So now you got the cofactor of other one. Next one, next element in that matrix is minus 1. So the cofactor of that element is, that particular element is represented by A 3 2, that is alpha 3 2, that is minus 1 raised to 3 plus 2. 3 plus 2 is 5, it's an odd number, so the sign remains the same. So when this element is selected, corresponding rows and columns are neglected. The remaining numbers are 1, 1, 1 and minus 3. 1, 1, 1 and minus 3. So if we cross multiply it, it will be minus 3, minus 1. So it will become minus 4. Here it was minus 1 raised to 3 plus 2, that is 5. It's an odd number, so minus 1. Minus 1 into minus 4, you will get positive 4. And the last one, 3. I hope you know how to find the cofactor of that element also. I'm not going to repeat it again and again. It will be quite boring. So you will get, by solving that, you will get the cofactor of that particular element is 1. So you can see that from this matrix alone, you have found the cofactors of each individual element. For each individual element, you have identified its cofactor. Now you need to prepare a new matrix on the base of this cofactor. And how you are going to prepare a matrix? So go for the first one, 3. How did you find this 3 on the base of this element? So you need to prepare a new matrix in which you need to position this 3 in which where the 1 was. Likewise, minus 9. How did you find here now on the base of this one? So you need to put this minus 10 in that particular position. Next one, minus 5 on the base of this one. So in that position. Minus 4, again in the same position. Next one, 1. 1 is on the base of this particular number. If you have doubts, just go through this one. Here it is alpha 2, 2. Alpha 2, 2 means second row, second column. So you need to position 1 in that particular position. If you next one, 3. 3 is in 2, 3. That is second row, third column. Second row, third column. So this one. So let's see how we are going to make the matrix. So once you find the cofactor, you need to prepare a matrix on the base of cofactor values. So that particular matrix will be this one. These are the cofactors which we have found just now. 3, minus 9, minus 5, minus 4, 1, 3, minus 5, 4 and 1. And in the question you are asked to find adjoint. Adjoint is transpose of the cofactor of the element. Once you find the cofactor, you need to just position that particular cofactor in the corresponding element's position. So by positioning each cofactor, you get a new matrix. If you take the transpose of this one, you will get adjoint of that particular matrix. So this is the adjoint of that particular matrix. 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 9, 1, 4, minus 5, 3 and 1. So this is how you have to find the adjoint of a particular matrix. Now let's go for the main part of the question. In the question you are asked to verify a certain theorem. It's actually a theorem, but for the time being let us deal with the computation part. You were asked to find A into adjoint of A equal to adjoint of A into A, that equal to determinant A I. That was a theorem which were asked to find out. We found adjoint of A and A is given in the question. So let us do the multiplication part and we will discuss this part in the next slide. So first one, A into adjoint of A. We know that what is meant by A. A is already given in the question. This is the matrix A. It is given in the question. If you refer the next previous slide, you can understand. And adjoint of A, see, we have found the adjoint of A. Remember, all these steps may be find it easy, but these are the areas you may end up with some careless mistakes. So remember, here once you found the cofactor, you need to take the transpose, then only you will get the adjoint. Never take this one as the adjoint of the matrix. Whenever you take the transpose of this cofactor, you will get adjoint. So A into adjoint of A is this one, adjoint of A is this one, and we all know how to take the multiplication of two matrices. So by using the basic multiplication operation of matrices, you will get a computation matrix like this. By solving that, you will get a matrix. Okay. Now you got A into adjoint of A, you got a matrix, this one. Let us try the next one. Next, you are asked to find adjoint of A into A. That was the theorem which we have to prove. Adjoint of A into A means adjoint. See, adjoint of A into A. Here it is A. And we all know how to do the multiplication part again. If by following the basic multiplication operation of matrices, you will get a computation part like this. By solving this matrix, you will get another matrix of the same type. See, previously, by solving A into adjoint of A, you got one matrix. Now, by multiplying adjoint of A with A, you got the same matrix. You need to find one more calculation. Then only you can confirm that it is the theorem was correct or the statement was correct. Finally, you are asked to find, in the question it is asked to verify that determinant A into I. In the question there is no determinant, so let us find the determinant of that particular matrix. And we all know how to find the determinant. This was a matrix A given in the question. And you know how to find the determinant of this matrix. Determinant is computed on the base of values in the first row. And you all know how to find by following the basic steps for computation of determinant of a particular matrix. I am not going into detail regarding the determinant. We have discussed it numerous times regarding that part. So here first one is 1. So when 1 is selected, these four items become the submatrix. So 2 into 3, it will be 6, minus 1 into minus 3, it will be plus 3, so 6 minus 3, minus, remember this sign, minus, next element is 1, followed by the submatrix, remember, plus, you need to put alternate signs alternatively during the computation of matrix. So by solving that, you will get minus 11. So in the case theorem, it is said that determinant I means unit matrix. Or a unity matrix. And determinant I means you need to multiply determinant. Here it is minus 11, determinant into I. I is a unit matrix. We have learned that particular matrix. It is a case where the diagonal numbers will be 1. So if you multiply minus 1 this with this particular matrix, you will get minus 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 0, minus 11, 0, 0, 0, minus 11. So if you go through all these matrices which we have found now, you can see that almost all the matrices are the same. So in the question, you are asked to find A into ADA, adjoint of A equal to adjoint of A into A equal to determinant I. See, A into adjoint of A, we found C. A into adjoint of A, its matrix was this one. Next one, adjoint of A into A, adjoint of A into A, that is this matrix. See, these two are same. And finally, determinant I. Determinant I is here, this one. So if you look closely, all these three matrices, these matrices are the same. So we can say that the statement or the theorem which we are asked to prove whether it is correct or not, we can say that the theorem is correct, so it is proved. So this is how you need to deal with the various adjustment cases that comes under matrices. Here we have learned adjoint of a matrix and how to take the adjoint of a matrix. And at the same time, you are asked to prove a theorem. So just go through all these steps, familiarize everything. We will discuss further cases in the coming session. That's all for today.